Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains on YouTube with some scenery tips. A lot of times when layouts get started, they start with the benchwork, the plywood, the foam base, and then comes the risers. But then no one really has an idea. How do you make good scenery after this? Because we want to be able to blend the scenery on both sides of the risers. Now the risers in my situation are 1 inch, and I'm going to paint the top. They are glued down. I'm painting the top with just black acrylic paint. Once it's painted and it's wet, I'm going to place a piece of, I'm using 1.5 inch foam over top. I'm going to push this down because I want that black paint to mark on the underside of this where my foam risers are. Aha! Okay, this is just little tips. So now I was able to draw it out, and then I cut it out with a steak knife. And there! That was easy. Okay. The problem, it doesn't really look like natural scenery. I got to kind of cut away at it. So I'm not gluing this down just yet. I pick it up, and you can use like really coarse sandpaper or a metal file like I'm doing here. Gotta love the shop vac. It makes more appearances in my videos than I do. All right, so there's the shop vac. And now when I put that scenery piece in and I run my passenger trains, which is the longest cars I have, they clear. They're not rubbing against the hillside. Okay, so we're good on that side. Now on this piece, I wanted to kind of blend it in better with the height of the risers. So what I did is I took a steak knife and I kind of went parallel with the risers into the sides of this piece of foam. Kind of just more like marked it, really. And then I take it out and I use that as the guide to cut at an angle. I flip the piece over. I use liquid nails, just anything that works good for foam, like liquid nails for projects or even just says for foam. Put some beads down, smooth it out. You don't have to cover the whole thing. I mean, you're not going to be supporting any weight with it. And then just push it into place. Ah, starting to come along now. You can do this. This isn't hard. You guys can do this. I'm going to do the same to that. All right. So now it's starting to blend a little bit. But we got to cover up all that riser look. Those are the Woodland Scenics risers. All right, the next thing. Plaster cloth. Plaster cloth. Love this stuff. This is my favorite part of the hobby, actually, making scenery. So plaster cloth, I've done plenty of videos. This came from Scenic Express. You can get it from Woodland Scenics. You can get it from craft stores, medical places. You can kind of smooth out the holes right above the water, or you could do it on the layout. I just like giving different ideas. You don't have to follow everything I do. Exactly. There's plenty of good videos on YouTube by other model railroaders. But hopefully you like mine and I give you just a different idea. Use a combination of big pieces and little pieces. You just want to cover up all that white riser. Now liquid nails takes... I would give liquid nails like 4 or 5 hours to really dry, you know, get a good bond. I give plaster cloth maybe about half hour for it to completely dry. I poked a hole in my glove by accident. I just caught that. So using the plaster cloth, I covered all this part and it's all coming along pretty good. I kind of want to just focus on this for the video, but I'll show you some other things that I'm working on along this scene. Now that riser, that's going to connect the two separate main lines. We're going to tackle that in a little bit. But on the front of the layout, I had a half inch thick foam, and I just kind of made some almost like fascia with it. And it was the first time I ever used a hot glue gun, and it worked. So you can do that if you like hot glue guns instead of using liquid nails. I kind of like to hide some of the track. Okay, now sculpt a mold. Love this stuff. It's so much fun. I've done videos on this. You just simply mix sculpt a mold with water. And it gets all gooey and squishy, and it's a lot of fun. Now, a lot of times I'll add color to it, but I'm not going to do it this time because I'm painting the whole thing with a base color when it's all done, so that won't be necessary. So just for this video, I'm going to use the sculpt a mold, just kind of glop it up against the ramp. And I use both the inside of my hand and the back of my hand. Just little tricks that I do to kind of like push it in. I want to add angles. Kind of smooth it out. So yeah, this is fun, man. If you guys can start like seeing the fun and making layouts like this stuff, this is good stuff. And so here I'm doing it along the front of the layout. Sculpt the mold, the wetter it is, the smoother it's going to be and easier to kind of fill in some of those little holes of plaster cloth. It's going to dry probably in about anywhere from 3 to 8 hours, depending on your humidity. So you can see the front of the layout. Now, I had a little too much caffeine, and I decided just to paint this thing at 300 times speed here. No, seriously, this is just simply brown acrylic paint. I went to Walmart, and I said, "Do you guys have your return section?" And he's like, "Yeah." And I got a can of brown paint for $15.55. Probably the cheapest you're going to find it right now. And this is a base coat. Okay, it's not going to be the final coat, but I'm covering up all the pink, all the white. And then if any of my scenery comes loose, I'd rather have them see brown than pink or white. Just gives me something good also for the seating material to hold on to. And I'm going to do everything you see that's pink or white is going to now be painted brown. And it's almost like having a clean slate of paper to work with. It helps me. So here we see Amtrak, and it is headed into a very bright sunrise this morning. But we're going to see that the track is cut into a hillside. If you can kind of squint and look to the right, you see that the road is lower. We'll flip the camera around the other direction, and we see another vantage where the track is cut through the hill and on a curve. As the tracks head towards the city of Pittsburgh, we see the town of Braddock is built on both sides. And it's just like our layout. It's almost like if it was on risers and the scenery is being built up on both sides like we did. Now, I took the track off, and I'm going to paint it just a little bit lighter, closer towards the tracks. The truth is, the earth is really a lot lighter color than you may think. So we lightened it up a little bit with some white, some light brown, and a tiny drop of black. I like to just blend and mix my colors. And I'm painting basically everything that was sculpt a mold. So if it's still the base color, that's going to get like darker green foliage and other scenery. But here, what I did is I wanted to experiment with this. I put a little bit of orange down. This is going to be basically where the forest is going to start. And we all know the forest floors really are orange from all the dead leaves. Now this is white Elmer's glue. It's not diluted. It's just basically straight from the bottle. Now my scenery, that bowl, I mix my colors. Always mix your colors. So we have a little bit of yellow grass. We have some light green grass. I put some dirt, some real sifted dirt in there, and even some black cinders. Now you can use a spoon or whatever. I just decided to use my fingers while the white glue was still wet. In some areas, I added a little bit more green. It's okay to just keep changing your colors up a little bit. That's how nature is. It's not going to be all one color. And here we see how the track is now in the scenery. It's like it had to curve for a reason because of the hill. And we're going to build up the town in future videos on both sides. But now you can't even tell how it used to look with just the risers. It looks like real landscaping, real scenery. So I hope you enjoyed this. And in future videos, we'll be building more of the town. I'm going to show you how I ballast Unitrack. A lot of cool stuff. So thanks for subscribing to my channel, DJ's Trains. If you haven't already done so, please do so. I have over 300 videos, everything from life as an engineer to how the railroads really work, to modeling, to scratch building, a lot of cool stuff. You can also follow me on Facebook and Twitter and Instagram. And if you want to connect more personally, that's what the Patreon site is for. And all this stuff is in this video's description. So check that out. A lot of cool stuff. Also some cool updated merchandise. You might want to check that out too. So thank you for all your support. I appreciate it. And I'll see you in the next video.